Everyone, my name is Chloe. I wish to thank Gas for inviting me to Voices today on the topic I am extremely passionate about and wish continue to impact me on a regular basis. Without further ado, let's dive in. But first, a note on personality. As you may notice, I have a speech impediment. Please follow along with the PDF available in the conference portal to grasp what I am saying. Today, my talk will strive to explain and or reinforce the necessity of accessible documents and public secondary institutions. I will also provide tips to facilitate the process of creating such documents. Finally, I would suggest other learning components to consider when creating accessible documents. Let's start at the beginning. Why ensure the creation of accessible electronic documents? Well, these documents are an inclusive and practical means of actively ensuring meaningful engagement opportunities for all students between within both the classroom setting as well as the greater community. Here are some tips to making electronic documents accessible. Let's talk about multimedia presentation. Tip number one. Simple is better. Use a white background with black text. A plain font is always best, such as Arial or Times New Roman. The slides should also be clean, so avoid placing text and graphics all over them. Tip number two, try to create an organized presentation so that The information is easy to locate. The second slide should outline the titles of subsequent slides and the effect of the same topic on multiple slides. The term continues should follow the title. Tip number three. Graphic should always be placed beside the text, not in the middle or below the text. A description of each graphic should be placed directly beneath it. Tip number four. All videos and voice overs in presentation must be closed captioned. And finally, tip number five. Make sure the profile a PDF version of the presentation so that it is accessible to all students. Let's shift toward document. Tip number one. Similarly, the multimedia presentations organization is key. Font should be Arial or Times New Roman, and headings should be used to differentiate each section. Additionally, each paragraph should be titled. These elements facilitate navigating within the text. Tip number two. Lists should be created with built-in list tools to make them more obvious. Tip number three. Again, ensure that alternative text is available for each graphic. There is typically a built-in function, but the description can also be inserted directly below the graphic. Finally, tip number four. Tables can be quite inaccessible and should be used with caution and only when absolutely necessary. multimedia presentations and word documents are the most prominent tools used within the post secondary setting, but evidently they are not the only ones. Remember, the verify accessibility of all PDF surveys and websites that will be navigated by students. Removing barriers is sometimes challenging, especially when individuals do not know where to begin. I hope that through this presentation, I have provided valuable tips that will make the process of creating accessible documents less daunting. Thank you for your time, and please do not hesitate to contact me. My email can be found on the slide. I will leave you with a few resources that can offer further guidance in creating accessible documents.